싫은데.
기분 싫은데.
사람이 빠진 게.
젤렌스로 사람의 서스! 드리길라이 하드라이 실망!
오케이.
저희가 방 하이로 유발 나온 비행군.
Doctors, nurses, health workers, all the residents of this particular district, old people, respected senior citizens, our respected mothers, sisters, young friends, media friends, I think it's a very, very happy occasion for all of you, but I think more than all of you, for the health minister of the country and for the prime minister of the country. And of course, I can say that for your chief minister also, it is a moment of great privilege. And I have come here with all the good wishes of our dear prime minister, who, when he planned during his second tenure as prime minister, 2 years back, one of the first cabinet decisions was to create 75 new medical colleges in the country, and it was decided that these medical colleges will be created in districts where the most deprived, poorest of the poor people, whom we can say they have been deprived of the best possible facilities for years and decades, those districts and those places have been chosen. And Mon being one such place where we have already got a district hospital, but I am sure that this foundation stone that is being laid today by me and by the Honorable Chief Minister in the presence of the Honorable Health Minister, MP and all of you, this is going to be a great day in the history of medical education in the country and more particularly for Nagaland, because this is going to start a new movement for medical reforms in the country. So I wish you all good health. You have already done so well during 2020, the COVID pandemic, and I am sure that with the creation of a new medical college here in the coming years, new doctors will emerge from this district, which will serve Nagaland and the country in the most selfless manner. So my heartiest congratulations to the people of this particular district, Mon, and also to the doctors, nurses and other colleague health workers who are working in this facility, who will soon in coming years see a medical college emerge from this district hospital here. Thank you so much for this very, 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 very touching reception from the place where I landed from the chopper to this place. I have seen huge crowds of young women, young boys and young men welcoming from the core of their heart, showing their happiness and their delight, and it has been a treat to receive or being a part of this welcome ceremony also. So my heartiest congratulations and prayers to God for your welfare. Thank you.
Wait, sir, wait.
Yeah.
Honorable Union Minister for Health and Family Welfare, Science and Technology and Earth Sciences, Government of India, and His Lady Wife, Honorable Chief Minister, Honorable Member of Parliament Lok Sabha, Honorable Chairman PDA, Honorable Cabinet Ministers of Government of Nagaland, Honorable Advisors, Honorable Elected Members, Administrative Heads and Heads of Departments, respected civil society and church leaders, guests and ladies and gentlemen, wish you all a very pleasant morning. I have the proud privilege to welcome each and every one of you to the foundation stone laying ceremony of Medical College Mon, which is one of the 75 colleges being set up across the country under phase 3 of the centrally sponsored scheme of establishment of new medical colleges attached to district or referral hospitals. 26 February 2021 will go down in history as a red letter day of not just Mon district, but also of a beautiful state of Nagaland. A day which gives further fillip to a collective resolve to strengthen the last mile health service delivery. A day that heralds a new dawn in our continuous quest to restructure and strengthen the health delivery mechanism for equitable, affordable and quality healthcare for people in the remotest corners of the state. I would like to take this opportunity to briefly introduce my district for our guests. Mon district, popularly known by the epithet the land of Angs or Kings, was carved out of Tuen Sang district on 21st December 1973. It is situated in a region that can be practically characterized as the northeast of the northeast. The number 3 has a twin significance for Mon. It's the third most populous district as well as the third largest district in terms of area. It's home to the Konyak Nagas. The Konyaks are numerically the single largest tribe in all of Nagaland, with a large number of Konyaks living in Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, and across the international border in Myanmar. They are amongst the kindest and nicest people you'd find anywhere on the globe. There are several aspects that set Mon district apart, be the headhunting practices of the past, or the rich culture and practices that include the system of Angs or Kings, the body tattoos, and the indigenous art of making muscle-loading guns or distinctive handicrafts. As we formally begin the program, I'd now like to request Reverend M. Chemyu Konyak, Executive Secretary KBBB, to invoke God's blessings in our midst.
Before I pray, let me read one scripture portion taken from Proverbs chapter 16, verses 1 and 3. The preparation of the heart belongs to men, but the answers of the tongue is from the Lord. Commit your work to the Lord, and your plan will be established. This is the word of God. Let us pray. Let me pray for all of us. Kadok bangdang semilambi ha saydang mayungwan pag kawang. Naga katalan jing na muhiman bunyi. Anyay na hadaw district jing na nangamung may bunap padam bujan minyong panam.
Reverend, our Honorable Minister, Health and Family Welfare, Government of Nagaland, Sri S. Pangyu Phom, has been at the front and center of the government's efforts to revolutionize healthcare delivery in the state. I now invite our Honorable Minister to please deliver the welcome address.
Respected Chairman, up to this inaugural foundation laying program, Honorable Union Minister of Health and Family Welfare, Dr. Harshwardhan Ji, and his lovely little wife, Sri Nadan Goyal, Honorable Chief Minister, Sri Nefirio, Honorable Member of Parliament, Lok Sabha, Sri Tokyo Yabdomi, my honorable colleagues, Principal Secretary, Health and Family Welfare, Government of Nagaland, State Bureaucrats, officers from the Department of Health and Family Welfare, Government of Nagaland, President ENBO and his team, President Kiyo and his team, leaders from different NGOs, press and media friends, ladies and gentlemen. At the outside, I take this privilege to welcome our most respected Honorable Union Minister of Health and Family Welfare, Science and Technology, and Earth Sciences, Coromandel of India, to this remote corner of the country to grace the historic occasion of lying up on this stone at Medical College, Mount Nagaland. It is the most desire of the people of the state to establish medical colleges, as it would not only produce the much needed manpower, but will also enhance the delivery of tertiary healthcare in the state. This is, in turn, would elevate the undue financial, physical, and psychological burden of the patients and their relatives who are compelled to seek treatment outside the state and will have lack of proper tertiary healthcare services in the state. Today, we are honored to have you in tracing the first step towards realizing our dreams. True to its concerns and commitment for upliftment of the state, the central government has sanctioned for two medical colleges to the state of Nagaland. Indeed, the state has never had such privileges in its history since statehood. And that I'm grateful to you, sir, and the Government of India under the dynamic leadership of Sri Narendra Modi ji, the Honorable Prime Minister of India, for sanctioning this college for the people of Nagaland and beyond to address our acute shortage of doctors and to improve the healthcare delivery system, particularly to reach out the needy people in remote and unserved areas. At the time of Nagaland, it then stood hot in 1963. It inherited a rudimentary health infrastructure comprising of 27 hospitals and 33 rural health centers with a total of 689 hospital beds. Since then, the government has steadily strived to restructure the delivery mechanism for health to enable provision of universal action to equitable, affordable, and quality health care responsive to the people's needs. From this humble beginning, today, the public health infrastructure has increased to 11 district hospitals, 2 TB and chest diseases hospitals, 1 mental health hospitals, 33 community health centers, 143 primary health centers, 583 soap centers, 2 big dispensaries, and 1 subsidiary health center. Private health infrastructure is mostly concentrated in Kohima and Dimapur districts. Therefore, majority of the population is dependent on the public health system. However, delivery of quality care is still far from satisfactory due to the lack of proper health infrastructure owing to resources constraints. On the other hand, physical accesses to healthcare services is also affected due to the problems associated with difficult terrain, lack of proper road communication and transportation facilities. They said Kaman has achieved remarkable health development over the past decades, as evident from the key health indicators. However, responsiveness of the health system to people's needs and growing expectations is still far from satisfactory, and many challenges pertaining to accessibility, availability, affordability, and quality of healthcare services are yet to resolve. Besides, resurgence of communicable diseases, increasing burden of the emerging communicable diseases like Chi, Dengue, HIV, AIDS, etc., non-communicable diseases, lifestyle-related diseases, and increasing elderly population, if not addressed with urgency, would undermine the health and developmental gains made so far. The PDA government, under the dynamic leadership of our Honorable Chief Minister, Sri Nipiru, is committed to strengthen the health system and met the public health goals. In spite of many constraints, government is putting in sustained effort and accommodation of health, manpower, and accelerating health infrastructure development, as evident by the historic creation of 390 posts of various categories, health workforce, and health infrastructure development for effective management of the pandemic. However, being a revenue deficit state, it is difficult to develop a reasonable healthcare delivery system with the state resources alone. I take this opportunity to request your court office to extend your support in the following areas. Number one, support to address the health infrastructure deficit to enable delivery of quality care. Number two, support in providing residential quarters for health workers, a service delivery and availability health worker at the grassroots level is affected due to lack of quarters. Number three, support in human resources development and health sector to date the rich human capital of the state. Number four, support in establishment of infectious hospital attached to every district hospital for effective management of infectious diseases. The lack of such facilities has been felt much during the COVID-19 pandemic. Number five, support in developing cancer care and control services, as Nagaland is one of the highest burden states in the country in terms of cancer incidence and prevalence. Lastly, the community participation and ownership shown by the people of Mon and working together with the government, including this project, to establish a medical college is exemplary. The involvement and participation of the people only strengthens the state's communitarization policy as a developmental strategy and fundamental requirement to achieve health and sustainable development. I urge the people of Mon to continuously extend your cooperation and support to jointly establish this medical college and make a healthier and more prosperous society. Jai Hind, Kognalem.
Thank you very much, sir. We're incredibly grateful for your tireless efforts for the establishment of this medical college and turning our dreams into reality. As we move on with the program, I'd now like to request Sri Amardeep S. Bhatia, IAS, Principal Secretary, Health and Family Welfare, Government of Nagaland, to present an overview of the project to this august gathering.
Chairman, Deputy Commissioner Mon, Honorable Union Health Minister, Honorable Chief Minister, Honorable Member of Parliament, Cabinet Ministers and elected representatives, ladies and gentlemen, it's a proud privilege to be part of this foundation stone laying function today and to give you an overview of the project that we are going to implement for the Mon Medical College. Last year, the Honorable Chief Minister had written to the Honorable Prime Minister requesting for establishing a medical college at Mon. The Honorable Union Health Minister had approved, and accordingly the project was sanctioned under the third phase of the centrally sponsored scheme of establishing a medical college attached to a district hospital at a cost of ₹325 crore. The project has broadly three components. One is strengthening of the district hospital. The second is establishing of the facilities required for running a college. And thirdly, running the college, which comes after the first two parts are over. This district, as all of you know, this district hospital was established way back in 1965. The key change happened around 2010 when Government of Nagaland, in partnership with Medicine Sans Frontier, decided to strengthen the facilities here. During the period of 4 years that this collaboration took place, there was a substantial improvement in public service delivery in the district hospital. After that, there has been no looking back. A new building has come up, the number of beds have increased. However, in order to be a full-fledged teaching hospital, we need to further increase the number of beds from the present strength and also increase the number of disciplines. We have already estimated what is required to be done, and we will be taking steps to ensure that the number of disciplines are increased to the required 23 disciplines when we move for an application. Second part is with regard to establishment of the college, which means the teaching facilities, the hostels, the residences, the library and other things, for which we have already acquired 30 acres of land in Mon, which is around 2 to 3 kilometers from this location. The civil society organizations of the district came together, and in the presence of Honorable Chief Minister, they resolved and gave their commitment to ensure that they will give their full support and ensure that no hindrance comes in the implementation of this project. This was a great step, because the ownership is clearly demonstrated in the resolution which was passed by Koniak Union, Koniak Students Union and KNSK. After the acquisition of land, we have already started the survey work. The contour survey has already been done. We are in the process of doing the subsoil strength as well as the geological survey, which is expected to be completed in 1 month's period. In principle, decision has already been taken that we'll take up this project on a turnkey basis, for which the required documents for inviting turnkey participants for the implementation of the project, the RFP documents are already under preparation, and they are also expected to be completed in 1 month's time, and we should be able to thereafter call for interested parties to come in. In addition, the government has also decided that the operation of the college, we will require private sector participation. So we are already exploring, we have already contacted some parties who have service delivery as a motto to come forward, and we will be taking this process forward, and in the next two years or so, during the time when the buildings come up, when the infrastructure comes up, we'll work out the modalities and ensure that the private sector participant is ready for helping the government in running this medical college. I'm very sure that with the ownership demonstrated, with the blessings and continued cooperation from the people of the district, the medical college can be completed within the scheduled time frame and will successfully run it thereafter. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, sir, for the detailed overview. We are forever indebted for your continued guidance and leadership as we go about establishing the medical college. Before we move on to the next set of speeches, we have a special song by a local folk fusion band, the E-Story. The song is titled Koi.
Oh.
Thank you, History, for this fabulous and scintillating performance. We now have short speeches by the President of the Konyak Union, the President of the Eastern Nagaland People's Organization, and by a beloved and renowned Honorable Member of Parliament Lok Sabha, Sri Tokeho Yeptami. I'd request them to please take time one after the other.
Chairperson, Deputy Commissioner Mon, our special guest, Dr. Harshvardhan, Honorable Union Minister, Health and Family Welfare, his lady wife, Honorable Chief Minister of Nagaland, Sri Nipiru, his Council of Ministers, advisors, and MLAs present here today, Honorable Member of Parliament, Sri Tokeho Yeptami, Honorable Bangyu Sir, Minister, Health and Family Welfare, Government of Nagaland, and all distinguished guests present here today. On this very auspicious day, allow me to place all glory and honor to our Almighty for bringing us all together. And I take this privilege in welcoming you all to the land of Ang. Since time immemorial, the Konyak Union, which is the apex social and customary institutions of the Konyak Naga tribe, have been shouldering and playing a vital role, voicing out for justice, true peace and progress in the land. And I'm sure that everyone present here today will agree, as I say, that this is the day that the Lord has made. I would also like to draw back the memories on our first meeting with our Honorable Chief Minister of Nagaland, where then he had expressed his visions for upgradations of district hospital mold into a medical college. Today it was through his undenying commitment. We are all here today to step into a new era with great hope and gladness. Sir, may your visions continue to search on beneath his wing. The Konya Kunan will also enter upon the brotherly affections and consideration made towards by Honorable Minister, who is none other than Sir Bong Yu Pong, hands in appreciation to such bonded gestures. Let our old chant, Amay Shua, reverberate, and let me wind up with the word Pushoi. Today, I on behalf of the people salute the dynamic leadership of our Honorable Prime Minister of India, Sri Narendra Modi, and especially to our Honorable Union Minister for Health, who is here with us today. Not only for bringing medical college to Mon, but for framing a national policy to save and uplift humanity. What more do we want as human? Sir, as we uphold you today with immense joy and gratitude, the Konya Kunan would also like to leave a burden upon you that, sir, please consider this very medical college as your own. Our people long to see the light. Sir, you might have heard about this region, and today you have landed here and you have seen it with your naked eye. Let me take this privilege to put forward that the word peace and progress is always synonym to each other. Give and take policy is unavoidable and it can be accomplished. Lastly, the Konya Kunan, as the sole custodian over its land and its people, assures full support and cooperation. May God bless us all as we say it into a historic chapter. Thank you and Pushoi.
Good morning, everyone. I, on behalf of the entire citizen of EMBO, welcome each and every one of you to the land of Angs. Before I deliver my speech, I would like to make a small presentation to our honored guest. So may I request our Honorable Union Minister, Health and Family, to stand up once, please. It's with love from the people of Eastern Nagaland. And it's corona free, sir. May I also request Mom to please stand up once. Respected Chairman, the Deputy Commissioner of Mon, Honorable Union Minister for Health and Family Welfare, Dr. Harshvardhan, Honorable Chief Minister of Nagaland, Sri Nifirio, Honorable Member of Parliament, Dr. Yoyeptomi, Honorable Minister for Health and Family Welfare, Sri Bong Yu Pong, Honorable Inu Members, Advisors, Bureaucrats, Technocrats, Dignitaries on Dais, Ladies and Gentlemen. I take this privilege to stand in front of you on behalf of all the entire citizens of Eastern Nagaland to say thank you to the Government of India, led by our visionary Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi, and also with the participation of our Honorable Union Minister Dr. Harshvardhan, for letting
the dreams and aspirations of the people of Eastern Nagaland come true. I would also like to appreciate and extend my deepest appreciation to our Honorable Chief Minister of Nagaland, Srini Firio, for remembering the people of Eastern Nagaland and blessing the medical college in the land of the people of Eastern Nagaland. Your contribution towards the people of Eastern Nagaland will always be cherished in the annals of Eastern Nagas. I would also like to congratulate our Honorable Minister for Health and Family, Governor of Nagaland, Sri Bangiphom, who is also the chairman of the Eastern Nagaland Legislature Union, for taking into consideration the aspiration of the people and putting forward the dreams of the people to become it into a reality. Today, with the laying down of foundation stone, we are hopeful that the pathetic health condition of the people of entire Eastern Nagaland will be improved at the earliest. Today, as we celebrate this momentous occasion, the people of EMBO will be expecting and watching the dreams, the medical college at Mon becomes functional at the earliest. May the good Lord bless the leadership of Government of India, led by our Honorable Prime Minister Modi ji, and may also God bless the Government of Nagaland, led by our Honorable Chief Minister Srini Firio. May you continue to meet the aspiration of the people in even in the days to come. Thank you, Kupnalim and Jai Hind.
First of all, I thank God for giving us this auspicious occasion. Respected Chairman, Deputy Commissioner Moon, respected Honorable Union Minister, Health and Family Welfare, Science Technology, Earth Sciences, Dr. Harsh Vardhan, his beloved lady wife, Madam Nutan Goel, Honorable Chief Minister of Nagaland, Srini Firio, Honorable Minister Health and Family Welfare, Sri Bangiphom, all the Honorable Ministers, Advisors, Members of Nagaland Legislative Assembly, respected Mr. Bhadia, Principal Secretary, Health and Family Welfare, officers and staff of medical fraternity, President KU, President ENPO, host of dignitaries, ladies and gentlemen. On this auspicious day, I want to take the privilege on behalf of the people of Mon district, in particular, and Nagas in general. Sincerely thank the Honorable Minister of Health and Family Welfare for fulfilling our long cherished dream to have this medical college here in Mon district headquarters. This has been made possible because of the blessings of our Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji, and also with the initiative of Honorable Chief Minister of Nagaland Srini Firio and the Honorable Minister Health and Family Welfare Sri Bangiphom. Ladies and gentlemen, under the leadership of our Honorable Prime Minister, this has been made possible. and in his 7 years in office, lot of development is taking place all over the country. And he is one of the prime minister who has visited nooks and corners of the country. And with his vision to make India a vibrant and powerful economic country, the great India is marching ahead. Therefore, I would like to request all of us to put our heads together and then continue to pray for the leadership of our Honorable Prime Minister, Honorable Health and Family Welfare Minister, Dr. Harshvardhan, even in the days to look after our welfare. I would like to share few words in Nagamis. Aji adi yedi ahigena yedi program diju dibo parise etu karani isorke dhinyabad de ase amakan idia india di development bishi ja ase aji kali phitor di prime minister du assam di majuli island di 8 kilometer bridge foundation stone lay kuri dise etu maina first week the Deputy Medical College inauguration kurisha. Aji eti ama Honorable Minister Medical College disha. Tai ahi kena building banabole nohoy, infrastructure sabole nohoy. Tai to amakhan ke disha. Kurubo no kurubo amakhan upoti ase. Etu karni ama Honorable Chief Minister Tai laga wisdom aro honorable health and family welfare tai dujon itu medical college yeti dise ami khan state capital kohima chari gena itya 11 district headquarter ase kintu 11 bhitor di 10 ta district na pai gena aji ekta amamun district medical college paise kile अपना कान कोऑपरेशन दे और अपना कान दूसरा इरा निशना नहोगेना कि डेवलपमेंट दे इतु भाल कोरी साइगेना कोरी थाके इतु करनी अपना कान इतु भी किमान जल्दी लगे पारबो इतु कोऑपरेशन दिगेना कोरीले भाल होबो हम एकटा कथा कबो ए सीआरडीपी फंड पुरा चेंतंगिया तो 0.0.2 मोन Chengtangia to Amerangong, Chengtangia to Longlen, Chekabama to Chezuba and Zinibodo. 13 years Weshe Rasta Kodom Hane. Aji Amikan, Ama Honorable Chief Minister Yetiase, Honorable Ministers Yetiase, Honorable Elected Members Yetiase. Development to Anibo Hulebi Amakan. Development to hobo no hobo amakhan public property ase idya india di 29 state ase aro 6 union territory ase kiman development je ase dosra state di kintu kunba biya papa parai hole be ami ekta husa kotha kobo ami kan political unresolved laga upur karanpi development ti bish utubon origin ase de aro dui second ase article 371 a ama mon district tu itu bishino chalai hole bi dosra district tu homa bole bi article 371 a utubole bi article 371 a din ti bi article 371 a Newspaper, ami kile nagamis ti koy ase ami sorom ase amar dangre ausorte dupra itu koy ase newspaper da apnar kan dekhi ase আমার মাঠে আছে নদিব আমার মাঠে আছে নদিব কালি পরশু আমি পার্লামেন্ট খতম করিলে আমি রাইট আপ দিব আমার আসাম দি তেলে কিমান তাইখান লই কেনে চলাই আছে ইতুপি আর্টিকেল 371 উপরতে আছে আমি খান মাইন্ডসেট বুডলি নকরিলে আমাকে নাগাল্যান্ড কিতাবি ডেভেলপমেন্ট নহব আর ইতিহাসটো পৃথিবীতে ওয়ার্ল্ড তো হলে কিনিকা নিজের জায়গা ইকোনমিক ভাল করে করে কেনা যাব এই কথাহে করে আছে নহলে ইকোনমি নথাকিলে আপনার কথাটো কথা এটিপুরা দিল্লি যাব কইলে বি পয়সা নথাকিলে যাব নরব এটিপুরা গাওয়াতে যাব কইলে বি পয়সা নথাকিলে যাব নরব এই কারণে মুরুম করে কেনা দোসরা নাগা খানকে বি কই কেনা মাইন্ডসেট তো আমার নাগা মন বদলি করব লাগে নহলে ডেভেলপমেন্ট হওয়া নাই কোয়াতো হলে আমি খান ওপরটিহে আছে কিতাবি এই নহব লাগে কই কেনা আজি চান্স পাওয়ার কারণে এই কথা কয়ে আছে স্যার থ্যাংক ইউ সো মাচ ফর গিভিং দিস মেডিকেল কলেজ টু মন ডিস্ট্রিক্ট হেডকোয়ার্টার অ্যান্ড অলসো আই উড লাইক টু থ্যাংক মাদাম স্পেশালি ফর বিং উইথ আস হিয়ার টুডে অ্যান্ড আই বিলিভ শি উইল বি দ্য ফার্স্ট লেডি ওয়াইফ অফ আওয়ার অনারেবল মিনিস্টার টু ভিজিট দ্য স্টেট অফ নাগাল্যান্ড অ্যান্ড ইউ হ্যাভ বিন টু দ্য নক and the corner of the Nagaland state, which is bordering Arunachal and Myanmar. Sir and Madam, we have nothing to give you in return, but we shall continue to uphold you in our prayer to give you strength to serve the people, not only in Nagaland, but throughout the country. With these few words, once again, thank you.
Now have the honor to request our esteemed, dynamic and visionary Chief Minister, Sri Nephew Rio, to share his thoughts on this auspicious occasion.
Respected Chairperson, DC Mon, and our beloved Dr. Harsh Vardhanji, the Minister in charge of Health and Family Welfare, his gracious lady wife, my colleagues, Dr. Pangju, Mr. Pangju, Minister in charge of Health and Family Welfare in Nagaland, other colleagues, advisors, and honorable MLAs, respected Reverend M. Jimyuk Konyak, Executive Secretary, KBBB, and respected Principal Secretary Sri Amardeep Bhatia, other respected officers led by the Health and Family Welfare, district officers, and respected President ENPO, KU, and my friend Mr. Tokiho Yoptomi, Honorable MP, and most gracious lady wife of our Minister, Dr. Harsh Vardhanji, our doctors, nurses, and healthcare workers, frontline workers, public of ENPO, particularly Mon District,
friends from the media, ladies and gentlemen. It is my proud privilege to be a part of this historic occasion on the laying the foundation stone for Mon Medical College by Dr. Harsh Vardhanji. It is a long time dream to provide healthcare to our people, and particularly to the backward, deprived, and underprivileged people. When we declared Kipre as aspiration district, I was all the time thinking that one of the biggest district and per capita income lowest district like Mon, we should do something special. In all these dreams and well wishing, our beloved Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji had come up with a brilliant idea, because he cared for the underprivileged people, for the tribals, OBCs, and people who live in the rural areas. Came out with an idea that healthcare should be provided to this nook and corner. And when cabinet had taken a decision that 75 most backward districts and underprivileged areas will be given medical college, it has immediately come to my mind. And we check up with all the departments, with the district, and Mon district could qualify the criteria. It is one of the biggest districts with populations, and also neighboring to Assam and to Arunachal and across the border Myanmar. If a medical college come up in Mon, then all these neighboring people who don't have healthcare facilities will be benefited. So I quickly wrote a letter to Honorable Prime Minister in 2019, September, and made an appeal. And I had discussed with Mr. Pangyu, who is in charge of health, and I started to talk with the Union Minister, Dr. Harsh Vardhanji. And medical college in Mon was sanctioned. I was very joyful, delighted, and when we discuss about when we can lay the foundation stone, when I talked to Vardhanji, he said, "Well, Rio, I would like to come personally and lay the foundation stone. But because of the coronavirus and because of his engagements, and finally he decided to come in the month of January, but the parliament has come in, so he made up his mind that I will come, but after the session." And that's how, by the grace of God, he and his gracious lady wife is here and just laid the foundation stone for the Dream Medical College in Mon. I, on behalf of the state, the people, and particularly ENPO area, would like to place on record our gratitude, our thanks to Honorable Prime Minister and to Dr. Harsh Vardhan ji for starting this medical college, laying foundation stone. Because of the situation and the works, Lord, that they have, it could have been done through virtue. But I was excited that he can come personally. And that's how we are here today. As the former speakers also had welcomed him and his wife and thanked them profusely, I join them and will always remember you in our mind, because it exhibits your concern, your commitment to create history with your presence in laying foundation stone. Now, this is the beginning of our journey for Dream Medical College. And without any problem, I learned that you could acquire land, about 30 acres. We, Government of India, may sanction the medical college, but the state government and the people of the area, of the district, have to partner. And in this, we have to improve ourselves, because medical college is not only for Mon district or ENPO. It is for people who are sick, who need healthcare, and it should be made in such a way that it is a center of excellence. We have shortage of doctors, nurses, health workers, and many doctors, specialists, super specialists, scientists, lab technicians, nurses from other states, from outside the state, will come. And that means, instead of we going outside our district, our state for treatment, people will not come only for studies, but will come for treatment. And instead of us spending our money outside the state or district, we will be giving service, and instead of spending, we will be earning. So the locals, they have to be prepared for all these things, because you will get different kind of services, you will earn money for your livelihood, and for any kind of services, you'll be paid. And therefore, the state government will give full support, the central government will give full support, but the people here, the area, the people, as you had the civil societies, frontier organizations, KU had made an MOU with the deputy commissioner that all is fine. And we had sanctioned the land compensation also. So it should be flawless. There should not be any problem. You see, when the principal secretary Bhatia Saab said the intention of how to build up this medical college, he mentioned that the state cannot handle. We cannot do as per the standard. And therefore he mentioned that for construction, it will be best if we give on turnkey basis. That means from A to Z, when one project comes, we have 20, 30, 40 contractors. But turnkey basis means one company will do everything. Too many cooks spoils the curry. And therefore, a professional company, builders on turnkey basis, they should construct the infrastructures. That is in the mind, and we shared the other day when we had the video conferencing with Honorable Prime Minister. I thank him for the medical college sanction. I also told him that we need your constant support. And we are thinking, contemplating that this Mon Medical College will be on PPP mode, private partnership. Because you need doctors, you need specialists, super specialists, you need scientists, you need lab technicians, and so many administrations are required. And to make it really successful and center of excellence, we should have an experienced hand who are already handling other medical colleges or running good, excellent hospitals. And this is how we were discussing. There we have to be together and we have to be consensus. You see, Nagaland, we don't have sufficient doctors, nurses, or laboratory technicians. Fortunately or unfortunately, when coronavirus, the COVID-19 came, we realized that our healthcare facilities are not in order. There's huge shortfall of qualified doctors, qualified nurses, and we did not have even single RT-PCR, not even one. And we are sending our samples to Manipur and Assam. But we decided, and we could make 2 PCR, and now the testing is going smoothly, and TrueNets are everywhere, including the private hospitals. So we are better off, and we had upgraded our healthcare hospitals, CHA, and PSCs and CHC centers. In this, though the financial resources was a concern, we had post creation was banned, fresh appointments were banned, but on emergency in medical department, for your kind information, we had created 390 posts in medical department. 120 post creation for doctors, 221 for nurses, and the rest, the lab technicians and scientists. And that's how we could, with the community support, and all the healthcare workers, frontline workers, and the community. We could overcome the COVID-19, though we had brought down to a minimum. The COVID-19 virus came with the migrants or with the returnees of the Nagas who are studying outside the state, particularly in the cosmopolitans. And that's how we had handled. We are grateful to the healthcare workers, the frontline workers, the tribal leaders, and the mass-based civil societies, particularly even the church. The church volunteered to cook food for the people who are tested positive and staying in the quarantines. And that's how today, for a few days, there was not even a single positive cases. I think yesterday, 6 was tested positive. So we have come to that level, and we are better off. And with this medical college again, particularly in the ENPO area, healthcare will improve tremendously. But we have to also change our lifestyle. And we have to participate so that people will be willing to come to serve us. Your doctors, nurses, they will get job anywhere in the country, in the world. But because of some special reason, we should expect them to come here. Or even medical students, we should make them wanting to come to our place. And therefore, that depends on us. Therefore, the partnership of the government, central government, the state government, and the local people, we have to turn, we have to partner to make this dream come true. And I'm sure, together, we can achieve, we can realize our dreams in the service of the people. Unless the citizens are healthy, we cannot progress. A sick person cannot function. As the saying goes, health is wealth. And therefore, we want our family, we want our community, we want our people to be healthy so that they can take up any challenges and so that we can be at par with others in any activities. So with these words, I wished all the very best to the department, to the local people here, and to all of us that will make this a dream come true and not waste the vision or the labor. These few words, God help us, Kugnalim.
So first, I'd like to request a Honorable Union Minister for Health and Family Welfare, Dr. Harshvardhan, to please stand at a seat, please. Thank you. He will be felicitated by the President of the Konyak Union, Sri Hoving.
The Shosho is symbolic of the identity of the Konyak Naga men. The sash or taupak is also a symbolic costume of a warrior man. The machete or yam is a symbolic tool used for or during warfare and cultivation. The muzzle loading gun or la is used for hunting, warfare ceremonies and festivals. Today, the muzzle loading gun and gunpowder is always synonymous with the Konyak Naga.
Dr. Harshvardhan, Honorable Union Minister for Health and Family Welfare, Science and Technology and Earth Sciences, needs no introduction in the national or international arena. He has a long and distinguished record of public service, leaving his indelible mark in all fields of activity undertaken. An ENT surgeon by profession, Dr. Vardhan branched out into public life in 1993. He's been elected to the Delhi Assembly for a record 5 consecutive terms in 1993, 1998, 2003, 2008 and 2013, and to the Lok Sabha in 2014 and 2019. His public life has been marked by outstanding achievements in the fields of health, education, law, science and technology, and environment. As the country's health minister, his graded, proactive and preemptive approach enabled the country to decelerate the pace of the COVID-19 pandemic, and it has won him all-round international applause and recognition. Early in his public life, he was instrumental through the mass countrywide campaign in wiping out polio from the face of India. Subsequently, he was at the forefront of the battle against tobacco and drug abuse and was instrumental in the enactment of several laws, including the Delhi Prohibition of Smoking in Public Places and Non-Smokers Health Protection Act to tackle these problems. Subsequent to this, the Supreme Court directed all states to replicate this law, and 12 states enacted similar laws. He, for the first time, implemented the rational drug policy, which was recognized by the World Health Organization, WHO, as the Delhi model and was adopted by many countries. With a stellar CV matched by few people around the world, he is a global thought leader. Sir, we're incredibly honored to have your presence here today. I would now like to request you to please address this magnificent gathering.
Chairman of this very prestigious function, Shri Thavaseelanji, the Deputy Commissioner of Mon District, my dear friend and also for 5 years colleague in Parliament and also your Chief Minister 4 times, MLA 7 times, and if I call him the Ajat Shatru of Nagaland, it won't be an exaggeration. Shri Nipyo Ryoji, the Honorable Chief Minister of Nagaland, we are extremely privileged to have his presence today at this function. Our dear Shri Pangyu Phom, Honorable Minister, Health and Family Welfare, Government of Nagaland, who is also gracing the occasion and who has also been like the Chief Minister pursuing this case of this particular medical college with me in Nirman Bhavan consistently. My another colleague in Parliament, Shri Tokeho Yathomi ji, Honorable Member of Parliament, whom you heard just now, his dynamic vision and his thoughts. Then we have the distinguished presence of Mr. Pai Wong, Konyak, another very dynamic MLA, and also one of the honorable ministers in the cabinet of Mr. Rio. Then the presence of Shri Chemyu Konyak, Executive Secretary KBBB, श्री अमरदीप भाटिया जी, प्रिंसिपल सेक्रेटरी हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर गवर्नमेंट ऑफ नागालैंड, प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ कोन्याक यूनियन हुम वी हर्ड जस्ट नाउ, ऑल्सो द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ एनपो, एंड आई अंडरस्टैंड डॉक्टर एस्थर कोन्याक, श्री वांगिन वांगलिन, there is the presence of many distinguished MLAs here, health ministry officials, officials of the local district administration, the medical superintendent of this prestigious hospital at Mon, my dear professional colleagues, doctors, nurses, other healthcare workers serving this district, and respected and dear citizens of Mon, dear children, media friends, and all the other distinguished guests. Friends, it's an occasion which is difficult for me to describe in words, and it's beyond my linguistic abilities and vocabularies to be able to express my feelings. It is not that I am attending a function like this for the first time. I have been part of many, many functions like this in the last 27-28 years of my public life, all across the country also, and even internationally also. But there are many functions where you get the type of pleasure which you can call as a sort of an eternal pleasure. Pleasure which you enjoy at the level of your heart and also at the level of your soul. So this is also one such function. And this is because of the fact that this particular foundation stone is being laid at a place which is, as was described very well by one of the speakers, the northeastern part of the northeastern India. And I tell you that I was born in Delhi. I have been born in India like all of you, but it took me personally almost 6 decades of my life to first time visit any northeastern state when I became a minister in Narendra Modi ji's cabinet. Before that, it is not that I never wished that, but it never happened. And I remember that as a part of Narendra Modi ji's cabinet, we have seen how his heart beats for the people of Northeast, how committed he is for the people of Northeast. And from the day one, when he entered Parliament and he said that my government is committed to the poorest of the poor, my government is committed to the laborers, my government is committed to the farmers, there was hardly any cabinet meeting where he would not raise the issue of development for the northeastern states. And first 5 years, we remember that he made it a point. He assigned a senior cabinet minister to oversee how regularly the cabinet ministers are visiting Northeast to plan for various activities for the development of northeastern states. And this is not something which is happening only in the field of health, that the northeastern part of the northeast of India is getting a medical college in a district where in spite of being such a big district, where you have, as was said by the chief minister, you've got the lowest per capita income, but the government of Nagaland supported and of course blessed by the Prime Minister of India, had the vision to ensure that even a place like this in such extreme corners of the country is not deprived of the various facilities and the various services. So many things have happened in the last 7 years in particular on all fronts, whether it is connectivity in the air, whether it is connectivity on the road, whether it is connectivity through the railway network. So much has happened and so much is likely to happen in the next few years, and of course on the health front, the education front, the skilling front, any front that you talk about. This is not the occasion where I can describe all those fronts, but we feel so satisfied and we feel so happy that we could, as part of the cabinet of Prime Minister Narendra Modi, could contribute something to actually see that his dreams are realized, his dreams are materialized, and there is significant, perceptible and measurable change on all parameters as far as the development of the northeastern states is concerned. And today when we are talking particularly about Nagaland, and I would love to thank from the core of my heart the people of this district, because the type of welcome that you had accorded to me and of course to the Chief Minister and our other colleagues, it's beyond any description. Or right from the place where we landed to the place where we are having this function, the huge number of young women, young men, boys, girls, children, everybody in so high spirits conveying their sentiments. And I think I'll certainly convey your sentiments to the Prime Minister of India. And I can also tell you that I have come here to bring back to you the good wishes and all the blessings and all the compliments from the Prime Minister of India. Today morning when we had reached the airport, we were told that the weather is not good. There was slight drizzle in the night, there were clouds, and it was predicted that we may have to, we really don't know whether we can really reach Mon or not, whether we'll be able to board the chopper or not. And we were just discussing, I said, what is the other option? Can we go by road? So they said it takes 7 hours. Then said, God forbid if it happens that the weather doesn't clear. But I said, when the clouds come and the slight rain, it is always a blessing of God. And the God is, I think, if the God is blessing the people of Mon with a medical college, God is certainly going to bless Dr. Harshvardhan also to be part of that function. So I kept on praying at the airport. And I told the health minister and the honorable member of parliament, and of course the chief minister was also there. I told them that even if I have to go tomorrow, I will not go back from Nagaland without laying this foundation stone, because it's not a routine function. For me, it is a God-sent opportunity to serve the people of the easternmost part of India with a medical college. And what could give the health minister of a country a greater pleasure than the fact that he is able to create one of those 75 new medical colleges? Although we had, when this cabinet note was approved, decided, and when we had drafted the rules for sanctioning of the medical college in 2019 after Narendra Modi ji took over his second term. The first, one of the basic conditions of this was that the district should be a district inhabited by poor people, people who have been deprived of the various facilities in various sectors for years together, in spite of the fact that next year we are going to celebrate 75 years of independence. And that's how we had decided about these districts. And I have to congratulate and thank the Honorable Chief Minister and the Health Minister. They were very, very proactive. They were very, very energetic. They were very, very dynamic. They wasted no time. He wrote straight to the Prime Minister, and within no time they had a detailed project report made for this project, because that was also one of the sort of conditions to be considered for the proposal to be approved. So as compared to many other, because there were many requests from all over the country, and only those 75 requests ultimately could see the light of the day in terms of their implementation, where everything was in order. There was a good report, there was everything as per the government rules. So that is why we could see the emergence of this scheme, where the 30 acres of land just nearby, and have been the way it was described, that a lot of NGOs and a lot of well-meaning people here, they have actually promised and contributed to the arrival of a consensus for creation of this medical college. I am sure, because once a project comes up, there are many people who have to ultimately contribute, because some may be living there, some may have some issues, but then it of course requires everybody's cooperation. And the way the society here and the representatives here have all expressed their feelings, the way they have all expressed their gratitude, I have also to, like the Chief Minister, thank all of them for the great contribution they have made. Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji has a very huge vision for this country, and we have all seen that he has made a perceptible difference in all fields with his visionary programs. He doesn't only develop a program, he is a dreamer. He keeps dreaming, he keeps analyzing the problems of the country, problems of every part of the country. And he tries to convert those problems into programs, into visionary programs. And then he will ensure that all his visionary programs are converted into missions. And then he will ensure that his missions start getting implemented. And then he ensures that for the implementation of his missions, there is the involvement of everybody. It's not only the officers. There is the involvement of all the ministers. There is the involvement of all the state leaders. There is the involvement of the political workers of his own party. And then the greatest thing is that the Prime Minister of the country monitors every program himself. And you may find it difficult to, or you may not actually be conversant with this fact, that here is a Prime Minister whom we have seen for 7 years. Every Wednesday there is a cabinet meeting, but every month there is a meeting of all the Council of Ministers, which runs for 4 hours, 5 hours, 6 hours, 7 hours without a break.
And even the smallest program belonging to any department, its progress is reviewed directly by the Prime Minister. Some people may take a break for 1 minute or 2 minutes for reasons which are beyond their control, but we have never seen the Prime Minister moving out of that meeting where he is monitoring everything. So that is the fortune of India, where we have got such a dynamic Prime Minister. And this was because of the leadership of our Prime Minister that you can see that it is at the moment, if I have to count how many medical colleges are in the various processes of development since 2014, this is not these 75 only. It's a list of 157 medical colleges under various phases of development in the last 7 years. One of the other medical colleges is also in your state, Nagaland, the place where I may be visiting today or tomorrow. And Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji, another one of our dear prime ministers, he started the journey of the All India Institute of Medical Sciences with one aims being, you see, the scaling up of that number to 6 aims. And now from 14 to 21, we have got now under Prime Minister Modi 22 aims in various phases of development, one of them being also in your northeast in Assam. And I am happy to learn that this medical college at Mon, it's going to help people of Assam, as you said. Yeah. It's going to help people of Arunachal Pradesh. It's going to help even the people of the neighboring Myanmar. Yeah. Of course, and of course, this district and many places in Nagaland. Last 5-6 years itself, from 50,000 MBBS seats, we have now over 80,000 MBBS seats in the country. We have added almost 20,000 more PG seats, and many more things like that are in the offing. So many reforms have happened in the medical education sector. Our medical doctor colleagues, they will be able to appreciate the importance of the National Medical Commission and the Commission for Nurses that's coming very soon in Parliament. The Commission, National Commission for the Allied Healthcare Professionals is also it is under, you see, it has already been introduced, and maybe in this session itself, I'll be getting it passed in the Parliament. So there's so much that is already happening. Yesterday I had the privilege to visit one health and wellness center, where the government of Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji is in the process of developing 150,000 health and wellness centers all across the country, where we will see health movement around preventive, positive, and promotive health in that area. And diseases which are like which could become killer diseases, which could take your lives, non-communicable diseases and cancers and other things being diagnosed early with screening and so many things. I was told by Mr. Bhatia that some 370 of these health and wellness centers are in the process of being created. Half of them have already been created in the state of Nagaland. There are so many other support systems which have been promised by the central government. The support has been given. The Honorable Health Minister and Chief Minister has described them in detail. I don't want to get into the details of all that, but I can only tell you that our support for the people of Nagaland, our support for the people of Northeast, our support for the various schemes is not only theoretical, it is not on paper, but whatever we say, whatever we are trying to do, we mean it from our heart, and we are trying to put our heart and soul into every facet of development of the northeastern region, and particularly when we are talking about Nagaland. So it's a great moment, I am sure. And that's why I said that the feeling that I enjoy right now is difficult to describe in words, and I have to congratulate all the people of Mon, especially our senior citizens, because they are the people who actually deserve the maximum attention from the doctors and nurses. And I know, as a medical professional myself, who has spent over 4 or 5 decades in the field of health, not only as a union health minister, but also as a minister 25 years back in the capital of India, and also as an advisor with the World Health Organization, overseeing various issues in all the Southeast Asian countries. And I know how much health is important, and I would also like to use this occasion to highlight and once again express my congratulations, thanks and good wishes for the great work that our COVID warriors have done during the last 1 year. And unfortunately, we have lost some of our COVID warriors. We have lost some of our doctors, nurses, health workers, frontline workers. They were the ones who helped us. They were risking their own lives to save our lives, to protect our lives. And no words can describe the contribution of these doctors during COVID times. And it is because of their contribution that we have continued to enjoy throughout the year the best or the highest recovery rate in the whole world. We have continued to have the lowest fatality rate in the whole world. Our cases per million, our deaths per million, our deaths per million on any parameter, if you compare India with even the most developed countries of the whole world, many of the developed countries of the world are still struggling to fight against COVID. But because of the contribution of our COVID warriors, just now the Chief Minister mentioned, you just had about 6 cases yesterday, 6 positive cases. The whole country, we have seen over 1 crore 9 lakh people suffered from COVID. Over 1 crore 6 lakhs, they recovered, they went back home. The rest of those, the majority of those active cases right now, something like 1,40,000 or so, they are all on road to recovery. And under the leadership of our Prime Minister, with the contribution of not only the COVID warriors, but the whole of society, the NGOs, the scientific community, we have been able to ensure that we were amongst the first few countries in the whole world where we isolated the virus. We were doing the genome sequencing, we were producing the kits, we could become self-reliant in terms of our creation of our PPE kits, our N95 masks, our ventilators. We were supplying drugs to 150 countries of the whole world during COVID crisis. And today, when within the shortest possible time, our scientists have been able to produce and ensure a successful development of the vaccine. 2 vaccines have already got emergency authorization. They have already been given to our health workers. I'm sure all these doctors and nurses who are sitting here, they must have got even the second dose of the vaccine by now. So is almost 12 million doses, more than 12 million doses have already been given to our health workers and frontline workers. And it is not only these 2 vaccines. As a science and technology minister myself, I can tell you that almost 3 dozen vaccines are in under various phases of development in the country. Some are in the advanced phase 3 trial, some are under phase 1 and phase 2 trial, some are under advanced preclinical trials, some are under preclinical trials. And now, very soon, today is 26th, and when you just 2 days later, from 1st of March, we are going to enter into one more very, very important and revolutionary phase where the vaccine will be available to people, every person in this country who is above 60 years of age, and every person in the country who is between 45 and 60 years of age, and with many of these comorbidities, diseases like hypertension, diabetes, coronary artery disease, etc., etc. Patients with kidney, liver failures, cancers, etc. So, and all this is going to be made available to people of India in thousands of hospitals in the government as well as the private sector, just 2 days from now. And when I go back to Delhi on Sunday, from Monday itself, we will launch the platform on which anybody fulfilling the criteria will be able to get his appointment fixed for taking the vaccination, or he may also, he will also get the privilege to, even if he doesn't fix up his appointment, he can walk into any of these centers which runs into thousands. So all over the, I'm sure this may also be one of those centers where the vaccine is being given. So it's a huge achievement for the whole country. And the great thing that 2020 has seen, and I have to thank the health minister also, all the health ministers of the country along with me, and all the chief ministers of the country along with the prime minister, we were all on the same ground. We were all working together, following the same set of guidelines that were formulated by the central government and were passed on to the states from time to time. And everybody worked with utmost sincerity, utmost diligence, utmost honesty, utmost commitment. And that is why we could achieve, in spite of a crisis as big as COVID crisis, we could achieve significant results. So today I have to appeal to you, and of course to the Honorable Health Minister and the Chief Minister. There are a number of programs that are some of the ambitious programs of the government. You know about the Ayushman Bharat scheme, you know how much benefit Ayushman Bharat has done to the poor people of this country. Almost 1 crore 60 lakh hospital admissions of the poorest of the poor with portability. You belong to Nagaland, you belong to this Mon district. Tomorrow you travel to Delhi, you fall sick. Tomorrow you travel to Mumbai, you fall sick. Tomorrow you travel to Chennai, you fall sick there. You have to be subjected to a big surgery. You can walk into any of these 24,000 hospitals in the country. Many of them are the state-of-the-art hospitals in the government and the private sector. And you, if you are one of those 55 to 56 crore poor people, you get treatment free. The government of India pays for you along with the help of the states. So, there are so many schemes which are already working. But one of the most ambitious programs about which I wish to talk here is that we want to eliminate tuberculosis by 2025. And this is 5 years ahead of the international goal of elimination of tuberculosis, which is 2030. And I know with my own personal experience also that India, in spite of being such a huge country, if we could eradicate smallpox, if we could eradicate poliomyelitis, for which I personally had the privilege of being blessed by God to dream for a polio-free India and work for almost 2 decades, right from the time I was health minister in Delhi. And if we could survive COVID, remember the experts who came from America in March, they had predicted 300 million, 400 million cases for India. They had said people will die like whatever, means it was such a shocking description that they used to give. In villages, what's going to happen? In tribal areas, what's going to happen? That was the type of predictions that had been made. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 million deaths. But after full 1 year, if India could survive COVID, if India could fight valor with utmost valor and intelligence, I think we can definitely eliminate tuberculosis from the face of India by 2025. I want to take a commitment from the Chief Minister and the Health Minister that their focus on elimination of tuberculosis, and of course Mr. Bhatia, the Union, State Principal Secretary Health is also here, that they should make sure that tuberculosis is eliminated from Nagaland much before 2025. We have to ensure that in the universal immunization program, where 12 vaccines are given to children free of cost by the governments, with the help of the central government, each and every child in this country should get those vaccines. Not a single child should be deprived of the vaccine. And personally, I strongly believe that why should a pregnant mother die because she became pregnant? Why should ever there be a maternal mortality at all? This pregnancy is a boon. It can never become a curse. It should never become a curse. And we have to make sure that we reduce the maternal mortality rates, the infant mortality rates, the under 5 mortality rates to the barest minimum possible numbers in this country, with focused, specialized, brainstormed interventions, where the involvement of the medical community along with the administration. And of course, we have to underline the contribution of our workers in the field, and especially our ASHA workers, who are so committed. They are the ones who take all our messages from home to home. They are the ones who take care of our health in the field. So we have to support the healthcare infrastructure. We have to support the healthcare professionals. We have to support the healthcare workers at the grassroots level. And we have to take the support of all the voluntary organizations working in the field, not only the ones which are working in the field of health. My experience of having worked for polio eradication from the beginning says that everyone, every religious organization, every social organization, every political organization, every organization belonging to the resident welfares, they all have to be involved in the movement for achieving the goal of health for all. We have to be instrumental and supportive in creating a huge health movement in the country. And with whatever the great ancient health wisdom of this country is, and with whatever great DNA that we have, and with whatever great experience this country has achieved in the last 73, 4 years since independence, we are sure that if at all, if ever, The goal of health for all will be achieved anywhere in any part of the world. The first country to achieve that will be India, and our experience and our achievement would be worth emulating by the rest of the world. So let us pledge today in the presence of the residents of MoM and on behalf of the children of MoM to contribute to the realization of the dream of new India of our Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji by 2022, when we complete 75 years of our independence, where he wants smile on every face of every Indian, where he wants that every child in India should get adequate educational, health, nutritional facilities, where we are able to protect the dignity of our women, where we are able to take care of our senior citizens, and where there are only two things which should prevail in this country, extreme magnitude, and these two things I would say are either humanism and also nationalism. With these two guiding principles, if we all, as per the appeal of the Prime Minister, also develop a dream of our own to be contributing to something which will help us all in realization of a new India for all Indians by next year, I feel that will be the success of this program. Once again, all my good wishes to all of you, all my prayers for the good health and happiness of the people of MoM, of the people of Nagaland, for the people of the northeastern part of India. Thank you so much for your patient hearing. Namaskar. Jai Hind. Bharat Mata Ki Jai.
Thank you so very much, sir, for your enlightening and encouraging speech. We are absolutely elated and grateful for your continued patronage and support in our government's efforts for changing the face of healthcare in our state. As we approach the end of the program, I'd now like to request one of our most beloved, tallest and seasoned leaders of Nagaland, Sri Noke Wangnau, Honorable Advisor, Social Welfare, Home Guards and Civil Defense, Government of Nagaland, to pronounce the word of thanks.
Respected Chairperson, Honorable Union Minister for Health and Family Welfare, Government of India, Honorable Chief Minister of Nagaland, Honorable Member of Parliament, Lok Sabha, Zetokyo, Honorable Ministers, Advisors, and MLS, Administrative Heads of Departments, and representatives from civil society organizations, and invited guests. It is my privilege to propose the vote of thanks. I'd like to thank the Union Minister for Health and Family Welfare and his lady wife for taking time off from the headache schedule to be with us today. The people of MoM District are indeed the place to have your presence amongst our midst. on this auspicious day. I, on behalf of the people of Mon district, would like to extend my heartfelt gratitude to the government of India for providing us with the opportunity to finally establish a medical college which will cater to the medical needs of the people of Mon, neighboring district and state. I would also like to offer sincere gratitude to the Chief Minister, Minister of Health and Family Welfare, for extending their support, your support, in the realization of a medical college in Mon district, and also for gracing this occasion. The people of Mon will forever be indebted for making it possible. A heartfelt gratitude is also extended to the administrative heads and heads of various departments and civil society organizations of Mon, led by Konyak Union, for your cooperation and assistance. We request your continuous help for the successful establishment and functioning of the medical college. Lastly, I convey my appreciation and gratitude to all those present here and for being a part of a new chapter in the development of the district. With the permission of the chairman, ami nakamis na ektaruda ko sa kobo. Ito meeting ng college karni. Iman hindi ate juji na. Pabali iman tan. Iman project dangor. Mon district ahadong. Amalo khusi pabalage. Aji, दूसरा नागालैंड स्टेट न हो कि दो सो कॉल बैकवर्ड एरिया ईएनपीओ एरिया और लास्ट कॉर्नर अब नागालैंड मोन डिस्ट्रिक्ट तथा ईएनपीओ होली भी एरिया होली भी railway station, railway nearest to railway, nearest to airport, nearest to Assam. And facility jaga ase Mon district. Airfield khuli bole bahut jaga. Duk na ba bole jaga thakise. Ama nagalende ami election jaga na. बहुत चीफ मिनिस्टर अध्यक्ष काम करी से लेन मिस्टर जे विजोल बीसी पे गो चगाने कंसर्न गुरा एक ता थगी से तय मुरी जैस खाली पे गो कोथा गो गाने ता कंसर्न जी तो ताके ओलाई दिया रहे अमा गाने अपना गाने काम करा गाने Second, Mr. Ryu, the Chief Minister, tell you this. EMBU Jagade, but I Pakana de Joanni Senae, I had a head. Tonsang Jabo, Moon Jabo, Tubu Lunen Jabo, Ko Jagati Kiye, Abnake, Tahe Bishijani. Ito Machode, Ito Jagade, facility Bishop. Hello, communication. ब्ले चोइस करा कानी खुशी बहुत एक ता चारे दिए से अरो लकीली हेल्थ मिनिस्टर मिस्टर पागलू हमारे ये इंडियो बड़ा थकी से तब विशिष्ट मोंडी की ना ये दे अच्छी मित्रगल कॉलेज इमा दांगो प्रोजेक्ट खुशी बहुत कानी स्टोन ले करा दो दांगो कोता से इनका त्याग हम दे Mr. Gubang, land owner, type boat, pal jaga, elta dise, khushi poa janai dia se. Haro, tate, iman project dise, ami pikwar manu se, pikwar noho kani jate dia se. Kiman facility ayo, kiman doctor nurse ayo bules. Khali mohon disikwar nohoi, hola kalen asam, Bihar, UP, Burma. Rah, ini aja deh. Medical College, teh Buru College. Amak kerja pegawai lagi, buat budu sekolahnya aja. Itu buat mana kau aja. Delhi, Mumbai teh, kalau hiki boleh mau nuah manu, tadi caya aja, amak kerja manu. Ama INBO manu, ama naka manu, kiman khosa de jaya se. Dia, ya ta dhaki kita dusa jaka de na jau. Ita wa kha koles khuri se, mon de, kire dusa jaka de jaya se. Nija khoto, tanga kuri na. Nija khoto, pari giriwa niti bi na. Phal sokrato, phal students. Nore talented education de yade produce kui bina aji be iman mi tel college yade diya se central minister hai gana to dusra jaga da gana ama yade khali ho gana iman chotu moto ka ne kaja koi da thaki bola Aji leh guru saya, pakai kamp guru ni banyak manusia unit itu unit di taki ni, halal saran tu guru ni, alor action action tu komplain guru ni mana itu huni leh, banyak ceram kata om, ama banyak manusia itu jani bola ni, dua manusia syukur tu jalan ni dah, ni jadi kami sendiri aja, ni jadi rakyat aja, tuh kau mana? Supaya kami robo, tapi target diolah mana itu kota itu kita bi hold non. Amna sekian saja itu aja. Sebabnya amakan ya deh, aji, ima senior minister bra, aji deliver aja kena ya deh lagu se, amakan ya deh unity aja kena, kun bah hajarah kun bi, ikut kun tu kul suklu, dikdar kun kena, rasa panah omet deh, nolip building panah omet deh. Nolak itu cakap kani, kau kena halak kau tidak kile, ama kunyak kulak tu nohau, kunyak, yunin, hampir disen tu, kira tidak kile. Kalau dango itu lelap ang kau sih na, lelap ang mining jane, abni itu capable nolak kiri lelap ang, itu bukti bu nari le, itu decision juga nari le. Hakai disini ni sila ki kujak yunen. Hal guru kani dia sih. Guru kani, kami kamu dah doai, khusi bawa beram nak ikut. Ima antam mau projek dia tu. Doktor doktor nurses, maki bota, pura, IS pura tu, kau bawaan lah bawa itu kosan naik. Doktor kan tu Nepali pun, alat tak kan dia, alat thodne hoi jauh la, private. IS puri pun dah, doktor engineer puri pun dah. Iman, nak alat ente entem kau dah cakap dah, beku aja cakap dengan dia tu, so khusi pakai lah, kuno pun. Akhirnya juga tidak guna, nukul bawa kani, abis tanah dia se, thank you.
Thank you, sir. You expressed what was in all our hearts. Thank you so very much. This formally concludes the ceremony today. Thank you and God bless us all. Kuknalam, Jai Hind. The guests are requested to please stand by for certain announcements by accompaniers as the dignitaries exit the venue. Thank you.